Let never a man a-wooing when the lack a thing is three. A store of gold, an open heart, and full of charity. And this was seen of King Henry, though he lay quite alone. For he's taken him to a haunted hall, 7 miles from the town. He's chased the deer now him before, and the doe down by the den, till the fattest buck in all the flock King Henry he has slain. His huntsmen followed him to the hall to make them burly cheer, when loud the wind was heard to sound, and an earthquake rocked the floor. And darkness covered all the hall where they sat at their meat. The grey dogs yowling left their food and crept to Henry's feet. And louder howled the rising wind and burst the fastened door. And in there came a grisly ghost stamping on the floor. Her head hit the roof tree of the house, her middle you could not span. Each frightened huntsman fled the hall and left the king alone. Her teeth were like the tether stakes, her nose like club or mell, and nothing less she seemed to be than a fiend that comes from hell. Some meat, you King Henry, some meat you give to me. Go kill your horse, you King Henry, and bring him here to me. And terror struck him through the heart, and he knew he must comply, or the bravest man in all the land, King Henry, would die. Some meat, you King Henry, some meat you give to me. Go kill your horse, you King Henry, and bring him here to me. He's gone and slain his berry brown steed, though it made his heart full sore. For she's eaten him up both flesh and bone, left nothing but hide and hair. More meat, you King Henry, more meat you give to me. Go kill your greyhounds, King Henry, and bring him here to me. He's gone and slain his good greyhounds, though it made his heart full sore. For she's eaten them up both flesh and bone, left nothing but hide and hair. More meat, you King Henry, more meat you give to me. Go fell your goshawks, King Henry, and bring him here to me. And when he's slain his gay goshawks, it made his heart full sore. For she's eaten them up both skin and bone, left nothing but feathers bare. Some drink, you King Henry, some drink you give to me. Oh, you sew up your horse's hide and bring in a drink to me. So he's sewn up the bloody hide and a pipe of wine put in, and she's drank it up all in one draught, left never a drop therein. A bed. Now, King Henry, a bed you'll make for me. Oh, you must pull the heather green and make it soft for me. So he has pulled the heather green and made for her a bed, and taken has he his gay mantle, and over it he has spread. Take off your clothes now, King Henry, and lie down by my side. Now swear you, King Henry, to take me for your bride. Oh, God forbid, says King Henry, that ever the like betide, that ever a fiend that comes from hell should stretch down by my side. When the night was gone and the day was come and the sun shone through the hall, the fairest lady that e'er was seen lay between him and the wall. Oh, well is me, said King Henry, how long will you be my bride? And out and spake that lady fair, until the day you die. For I was witched to a ghastly shape, oh, by my stepdame's skill, till I should meet with a courteous knight who'd give me all my will. I've met with many a gentle knight that gave me such a fill, but you were the first of noble birth to give me all my will. Let never a man a-wooing when that lack a thing is three. A store of gold, an open heart, and full of charity. And this was seen of King Henry, though he lay quite alone, for he's taken him to a haunted hall 7 miles from the town.